The possibility of all-out hostilities between Russia and Ukraine has pushed the price of Brent crude oil over $100 per barrel, its highest level since 2014. Russia's action has also triggered concerns of supply disruptions in key commodities such as wheat and metals. The Philippines relies heavily on importation for fuel, especially now after the shutdown of the Shell refinery in Batangas. Because of this, local prices of pretty much every product and commodity is heavily tied to world oil prices. Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno has been quoted as saying their inflation forecast of 3.7% this year and 3.3% next year is attainable so long as oil does not breach the threshold of $95 per barrel.
We don't know yet. The situation is fluid. As far as the oil prices is concerned, our threshold is $95 per barrel. There will be no change in our forecast.
To be clear, the Philippines follows another oil benchmark, Dubai crude. That is hovering at around $91 per barrel based on online sources. Nevertheless, the Ukraine conflict comes at an inopportune time, with the Philippines dealing with elevated debt due to pandemic spending and the prospect of higher interest rates in the United States, which may raise borrowing costs and even cause some capital flight from Philippine markets. Political analysts believe the Philippines will not be spared of the possible repercussions of this conflict.
Naglabas na ng sanctions ang yes. US at saka yung Britain. Ang supply ng natural gas sa EU, sa European countries, maudlot. Pag nangyari yan, ang impact dyan kasi magsishift to oil mas more ang mga European states. Pag nagkataon, supply and demand yan eh.
Well, immediately you will see it in your pump. Because Russia is one of the, it has huge oil reserves. And if the market moves, because one of the main players moves.
Oil price shocks in the 1970s and 80s played a role in the debt and foreign exchange crises during the Marcos regime, when the Philippines was also dealing with rising interest rates and large amounts of debt. Jokno, however, says the Philippines is in much better shape now, and the economy and financial system should be able to withstand these circumstances.
I've been saying all along, the Philippine economy is much, much different than where it was many, many years ago. And unlike other crises in the past, we are not bothered by our lack of foreign exchange.
The Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry is worried rising pump prices, which have gone up for 8 straight weeks, will stoke inflation.
We have been adjusting our gasoline prices almost every week. And yes. That is a cause of concern because the inflation, the government would want it to be within 3%, but we've already breached 4%.
It's not just oil. Flour prices are also expected to rise since a large part of the world's wheat supply comes from Russia, Ukraine, and other parts of Europe. Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship Joey Concepcion said a supply chain disruption may happen if the situation deteriorates.
Commodity prices have gone to the roof. As you know, we import a lot of wheat. And wheat prices, it's just so expensive. So if that war breaks out, definitely there'll be a problem.
But this early, small businesses say they are already suffering from income losses due to price hikes in flour.
Mag-easy kami ng maraming paraan para makatipid, para maayos. Kasi ayaw namin ipasa yung mataas sa presyo ng arena sa customer, mawawala kami ng benta.
To ease the burden of consumers, lawmakers and civil society groups urge government to suspend the collection of excise taxes and other duties on fuel to cushion the impact of rising oil prices. However, government is unlikely to heed this appeal, since it stands to lose around 147 billion pesos in revenues this year alone if these taxes are scrapped. The government is instead pushing for fuel subsidies for the transport sector. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.